Hey, happy Wednesday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got some new updates going on for y'all as far as what's going to happen on this big storm. Matter of fact, I'm showing there's a great chance for multiple storms to be happening. Now, we still got this clipper that's moving through the Midwest, Ohio Valley, and the Northeast, and it's still bringing freezing rain, ice, and a little bit of mixed precipitation, but mostly rainfall. And even though the Northwest don't need any more, they have another atmospheric river coming. It's not bringing a lot of heavy flooding, but it is bringing a lot more heavy rainfall in places that don't need it. And if you've never been here before, hello, my name is Mark. I do upload every single day, just not Friday from sundown to sundown Saturday. That's Sabbath. But we'll make sure you are covered on whatever weather we will be having. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. I am all year long. And thank you so much, everyone, for the likes yesterday. I do appreciate it. I don't know if that's for the content, the special message at the end, or just for the links, or all three. But I do have some great links for you today as well. And thank you so much for sharing the video, because preparedness is key on big storms, guys. And not only one, but now I'm showing there's a good chance for multiple systems. So this could be a very big growing threat. So let's get to the information I have for you guys. And if you don't watch this all the way through, I hope you have a very great day today. Thank you for visiting my channel. Now, this link is always in the description to help save you time, but this is all your alerts, because you have high wind warnings and watches, as well as winter weather advisory, because there is some ice and freezing rain coming up to the New England states. But you can check out any time of day. It shows you the legend on the bottom, what your area is at warning for. Now, this is from Live Storms Media. I always promote their channel in the description of every video I do. That's a great group of people. This is all the flooding that was going on in Washington, guys, because that's why they had all them power outages. A lot of big flooding going on over there. But their links are always in the description for you to go watch the video yourself. I recommend you go watch it. It's a lot of great footage that they always do. But there was a lot of flooding in Washington. And this one is from Weather Nation. I link in the description as well. Bellingham, Washington seems to have gotten the worst of the flooding, because everywhere is flooded. It seems like they just really got the worst of the rainfall amounts. Once again, video in the description so you can go watch the full thing through. And this map is in there as well. You can zoom in and see where your area is, and you can see all the high winds that they already been getting in the Midwest. 59 miles per hour winds. They're getting snow in the Northeast. You can see that as well. 82 miles an hour winds. I mean, you got a lot of issues that really came out of Montana, 87, and the Midwest. And this is all moving to the Ohio Valley today. It will be a lot less. I don't expect 70, 80, even 90 miles per hour wind gust that was going on. It's going to be more like 30s, maybe low 40s. But you can see already that there's been a lot of snowfall already falling. Not a lot of people is getting it. Or 5 inches of snow. Some people is getting 5, some people is getting 3, and it's hit and miss because of the temperatures, but there is a lot of snowfall falling. Remember, this is in the description. You can always go click on your area and see what's going on. It'll definitely let you know what's coming your way. This page also there is your 3 to 7 day hazard outlook and see what's going on with the weather. And you can see right here in the blue, this is much below normal temperatures coming to your area. Right here in this bright green is heavy precipitation expected. The dark green is heavy rain. This is for the New England states. As well as this bright bluish green color right here, this is a heavy snow expected. But you can easily zoom in on this one as well and go see where in the south is your below average temperatures, possibly freezing temperatures that could be happening. As well as northeast, you can see who's going to be getting heavy rain versus heavy precipitations. But that will be mixed precipitation. But you can see the areas. It's from National Weather Service. It's a great map. And if you just scroll down, it'll show you all the hazards that we do have going on for this week. And most of it is going on for Monday through Tuesday. Also got this one there for you. This is for some more hazards that you will be having in the next 3 to 7 days. This is for a slight risk for heavy precipitation. And all this blue right here is a moderate risk for much below normal temperatures. And you can zoom in on this one as well and see which area is expected to below average temperatures from the previous map, the slight risk for the heavy precipitation on this map, and the moderate risk for the below average temperatures for the Mid-Atlantic and the Northeast. Now, we still have this clipper that's moving through the Midwest, Upper Ohio Valley, and for the Northeast as you go through Friday. And it won't bring a whole bunch of snowfall, mostly intercoastal, the snowfall that does bring, but it has lightened up because of the temperatures. But then we're going to get our big system coming still around the 22nd, and it's going to get a deep trough way into the south and southeast, and it is growing. And not only is it going up to the northeast, which I will show you why, it twirls there for a while, almost like a stall effect, because it gets blocked by some high pressures. At the same time, you get a second one that comes right behind it, and you get a 1-2 punch for the northeast. And when you look at your AO, your Arctic Oscillation, the GFS shows that it's still coming down around the 20th and 21st with this cold air, and it's still around the 25th for the coldest. It's not as deep as it was, so it's not going as far to the south. It's more like the southeast, mid-Atlantic, than the northeast. But you can see as well, when it goes from the 25th to the 26th, it starts relaxing before it goes up on the high ridge. And this is very important, because if it relaxes before the high ridge, more than likely it'll go out to the Atlantic before it goes on a high ridge to the northeast, instead of going straight to the northeast with them high winds. And you can see that here with the North Atlantic Oscillation, your NAO. It shows that from the 25th to the 26th, the GFS takes it on a little relaxed state before it goes on a high ridge for the northeast. And the Euro takes it from the 24th to the 25th, a nice relaxed state. Then it slowly goes up on that high ridge. So the Euro is showing worse winds, but the Euro is still showing it's going to be further offshore because it's going on a relaxed ridge, not on a very sharp ridge. GFS isn't showing as high winds as the Euro, but the GFS is showing a higher ridge, which definitely brings it to the northeast. So when we look for both models and check cyclonic vorticity and see what's going on with these systems, you can see we have the Clipper that's coming through the northeast, and the GFS agrees. It's not as strong, but it agrees that it is coming to the northeast. It's just Euro takes it a little bit stronger. And that next dip on the 21st goes deep into the southeast and the mid-Atlantic. And what you can see here is it actually stretches way far down. And this is actually one low-pressure system and another low-pressure system. And they both going to bang to the northeast, and this one's going to carry up like a nor'easter style. So it stretches far to the southeast and goes to the mid-Atlantic and goes into the Atlantic as a strong system. GFS confirms it does stretch down, not as far with the Euro as two different systems. Euro takes it a little bit deeper, but the GFS confirms that it will bulk up to a system right off the mid-Atlantic. And GFS takes it immediately real strong and tight to the northeast, right by the New England states, right on the 24th. Euro shows it'll still be a little bit further in the mid-Atlantic, like a little trough, and it's not going to form till a little bit later. Still somewhat close, but it's not going to be as early as GFS is showing it. So going up on a higher ridge with the GFS keeps it nice and tight on the New England states as it rolls through. Euro, which shows that from the 24th to 25th, it goes on a little bit of a relaxed state, then it tightens up towards a higher ridge, right towards Maine. And once again, this will be in the description as well. This is your three-day national precipitation type. And you can see for today, you have thunderstorms in the dotted green. And the full green is rain, mixed precipitation in the purple. And this right here is freezing rain possible. And I'm showing it's actually going to be some ice. As you go into tomorrow, you're still going to have thunderstorms in the south with more rain for the Ohio Valley. A little precipitation on Michigan while you still get mixed precipitation in the New England states and more freezing rain to ice. And by Friday, you got a next system moving in. You bring in more snowfall, more mixed precipitation, more rainfall for the northwest. While you're getting storms for lower Texas, Louisiana, southern Florida. Rainfall in all this green and mixed precipitation in all this purple with more freezing rain and ice possible for northern Maine. And I'm showing that these storms actually in the south will be around for a few days. Now remember, the zoomable map is in the links as well for you. So if you want to see what's going on for tomorrow and you want to see if you're going to get rain or precipitation, all you got to do is zoom into your area and it will show you if your city is expected rain or precipitation according to National Weather Service. We're talking very experienced meteorologists. This is more than likely 80 to 90% what you're going to get. Now this chart will be in the link for you as well. This is your time and date. That way you know exactly what storm I'm talking about, exactly which day. And just so you know, it is different from East Coast to West Coast, of course. So your 12Z would be your early morning. Your 18Z would be your noontime. Your 0Z would be late afternoon. Your 6Z would be in between midnight and 3 a.m., sometime around then, very early morning. So as you go through today, you have your Clipper in the Midwest bringing some snowfall, mostly on a wraparound because of the temperatures. Bringing rainfall and this low pressure system in the south will be moving to the east, southeast. And this is actually the system that's going to move to the northeast. As you go through noontime today, the rainfall amounts will grow. And all these red areas that you see will be areas for thunderstorms. As you go through this afternoon, it will continue to grow, especially for Arkansas, lower Missouri, and southern Florida. Early in the morning hours is really when you're going to get a lot of thunderstorms in the south, and it's going to start transferring over to the eastern Ohio Valley in the northeast. And by tomorrow morning, you're going to start getting the rainfall while you're still getting storms in the south. And you can see it on the northwest that you're going to start getting that atmospheric flooding once again starting on Thursday morning. By Thursday evening, you're going to be getting a lot of rainfall in the northwest, system getting even closer, a lot of snowfall as well. And you're going to be getting some snowfall in Michigan now on a wraparound, and the northeast is getting all their mixed precipitation and rainfall while you still see thunderstorms in southern Florida. Then as you go through Friday morning, you still see continuous heavy rainfall for the northwest while you're still getting snowfall as well. And you can see for the northeast, mostly intercoastal, on the wraparound, you will be getting some kind of snowfall accumulation while you still have storms in southern Florida. And then from Friday morning to Saturday morning, the storms are going to start moving away from Florida. Saturday morning to Sunday morning, that's when you're going to start getting some low pressure systems in the area. And this is more than likely going to make a clipper for you. More snowfall, more rainfall. But as you go to next Monday morning, then your clipper is going to move through to the northeast. And multiple models are showing different things. So on this one right here from National Weather Service, it's showing you're going to get a lot of rainfall from it. And as you go through Tuesday morning, you might get some snowfall on the wraparound while everybody else is getting rainfall. And then next Wednesday, it starts all over again, rinse and repeat. You have your storm system leaving out the New England states, very big system, while you have another low pressure forming over Oklahoma that will be traveling to the east. And this link will be there for you too as well, guys. That way you have your highs and your lows all through this week. And this is your low temperatures all week long, so you can follow this cold front as it comes through. And you can see how the cold temperatures, you're going to be starting off Thursday, it's going to move Friday, and Saturday is going to move to the East Coast. So it will be very cold mornings. But your highs will be a lot warmer. Your daily highs will warm right back up. So any snowfall that has dropped or ice will melt by then. Because a lot of people is not going to stay in freezing temperatures. The freezing temperatures are coming with that second system. And you can see your cold temperatures moving in on the 21st. And it will reach down to Ohio Valley, the Northeast. And it will go even far south to high 20s and possible freezing conditions for y'all as well. But you also can see as it goes up to the northeast, how the whole coast stays in warm conditions. So even though some freezing cold is coming, you stay warm along the coast because of warm dew points, because this system is so close to shore that it's bringing the warm tropical temperatures with it. So it's keeping it too warm for any snowfall. As these days go by, you get cold temperatures, but no cold temperatures on the coast. So it's very highly unlikely that you'll get any snowfall along the coast of the Northeast. It'll just be too warm lots of times. Most of the snowfall will be intercoastal. Now, even though both models are showing two different things, they're both agreeing that this will eventually become a cutoff low, which means it gets cut off from the jet stream and it can almost do a stall effect. Now, as we look for the 21st, you can see with the Euro 500 millibar height that our system does go through the Midwest. It does gain some strength, but Euro does show it weaker. As it goes on a deep trough, it does go to the northeast, and right there, it becomes a cutoff low from the jet stream. But as it goes through the southeast, you can see right there, it does become a cutoff low and just floats around a little bit by the New England states. Now, when you take this with the GFS, GFS takes it as a stronger system coming. It's definitely going to become a cutoff low from the jet stream as well, but you can see it does hang around for a good bit, and it's a stronger system and tighter to the New England states. So the GFS definitely takes it closer inland, so we definitely got to keep this updated on these winds. When you look higher up, you can see a little bit of what's going on that you really can't see. As we get this clipper come through the Midwest, it's getting blocked by this big high pressure, so it has to go up on this high ridge and get out of here. Then on the 21st, we get another system coming through, and this system will go through the northeast, kind of like a clipper, but we'll still get a coastal low that will form up with a potential nor'easter. Then as this high pressure block sets up over here, this system is going to go to the north, and this system is going to pick up its energy and just like grab the ball and keep on going and keep the storms coming in the area for northeast and the New England states. So in a sense, it gets blocked by high pressure, so it has to go north, but it can't stay north because it's blocked by high pressure. There's a lot going on. But so far, the Euro takes it where it's a little bit offshore. It still strengthens up to a 988, but as you can tell, there's not a lot of high winds anymore, a lot of tight isobars. That's because it's showing that the high pressure will relax and leave out the east, and it won't be smushing up against this low pressure system creating those high winds. And it's actually in a relaxed state, and it's able to push off a little bit further a lot less winds. But the rainfall amounts are pretty much agreeing with both models now. The Euro does show very heavy rainfall in the Northeast, especially for Maine. As far as your rates, the pink is 1 to 2 inches of rainfall. The red is 2 to 3 inches of rainfall. All this blue right here is 1 inch, and all the green is 1/2 inch. This up here in Maine, this is 4+ inches of rainfall, 4 to 8. Now, the Euro is making a lot of this snowfall. You see how a lot of people on the Northeast is not getting snow. A lot of it is intercoastal with the lake effect snow, the high winds, especially for Maine. But if you look right here for Texas, now it's starting to say Texas has a chance to get a little bit of snow, if anything. 1 to 3 inches, maybe spots of 4 possible. That's pretty fabulous being in the South. And the Euro is also picking up a lot of ice for Maine, up to 1/3 of an inch, mostly northern Maine. But still, it's picked up on both models. And your wind gusts, according to the Euro. So since the high pressure has relaxed and allowed the storm system to go out the east, instead of that high, tight ridge like the GFS is showing, the winds has come down. It did show that it keeps moving away, so it's a good thing it's not coming on land, according to the Euro. GFS shows something different. But once again, all this orange is 50 miles per hour wind gusts, with the red being 60s, this brown being 70s in higher elevation of Montana. And you can see in the lakes, you're going to be getting 50 miles per hour wind gusts, almost 60. All this green you see is 35 to 40 miles per hour wind gusts. 35 in the dark, 40 to the light green. So it is calming down as it comes over. And it's still showing 100 miles an hour wind gusts. It's just not showing the 117 that it showed yesterday. So it did mild down a little bit. Even though we're showing more storms as possible, the wind has calmed down. We will need to keep updating this to make sure this information stays calm. Since the models are in disagreement, I brought in a third model, the Canadian model, just to see what's going on. It's confirming the 50 and 60 miles an hour wind gusts for the Midwest, but it's also showing that the system will be a big system. It won't be as close to the coast like the Euro is saying, but it will be a lot of winds for the Northeast like the GFS is saying, because it's going to be a big system. So there's a chance for 50 miles per hour wind gust and all this orange and all this red, especially over here by Boston area. This is all chances for 60 and 70 in that brown. And the wave heights has moved a little further away as well, since the system is a little further off land, according to the Euro. It still shows there's going to be a lot of waves, and you can see which way they are flowing. So there is still going to be some onshore potential flooding. And the highest so far is 27-foot waves, where yesterday it showed 37. So it has calmed down, it has pushed away a little bit. But you can see it's still close to the coast, and there is still going to be an issue with some surge along the coast. But all that blue is anywhere up to 10-foot waves, and that green starts getting into 12 and 15-foot waves. All the waves are still offshore, thank God. But I also got this link as well for VentureSky, so you can go zoom in and see for your area, because starting on Tuesday the 23rd, 3 a.m., the system that's forming up off the coast is going to start producing some waves. And you can see the waves, how it does move and strengthen as it goes towards the northeast. And it is some strong waves. And this will eventually do some kind of threat to the east coast. You know how it does pull out, so be careful, whoever's swimming in these cold waters. But it's still showing 29, 30-foot waves way out here offshore. And along the coast, you're going to get anywhere from 5 to 10-foot waves on out. So it's not going to be super close, but there is an event passing by. Just keep that in mind. GFS also confirms that Clipper system on the 21st will go through the Midwest and Ohio Valley and bring a lot of rainfall, begin snowfall on a wraparound, but it also goes on that high ridge because it's getting blocked by the high pressure. At the same time, it will get a front-induced coastal low that will pop up, but it don't show it popping up like Euro does down here by Georgia and South Carolina. It takes it a while to get its vorticity, and it pops up sometime around the northeast. So this is literally by Tuesday on the 23rd, a second system pops up. So you could have a Clipper and a nor'easter popping up, bringing some snowfall and a wraparound, but a lot of rainfall as well, because bringing the warm temperatures with it. But look how big that system is, and it stays there for quite some time. So it forms up Tuesday morning early, and it stays there, and it just twirls with all that precipitation, strengthens down to a 988. So that is going to bring some more winds. Look at those isobars. Then it stays there for a while, bringing a lot of snowfall and them cold temperatures, and no more rain at that point. So it does stay there because it gets blocked by the high pressures. It does put a lot of precipitation on the wraparound and keeps a strong storm in the northeast. And by the end of the run, when it starts finally pulling away, it is literally 48 hours. So this could do a 24 to 48 hour stall, which could bring the snowfall for those that want it and a lot of onshore flooding for those that don't. And you can see the precipitation amounts with GFS, how it's showing the same thing pretty much as the Euro. It shows it's heavier for southern Texas, southern Louisiana, but it is showing all the heaviness in the northwest. But it's showing up to 5 and 6 inches for southern Louisiana and southern Texas as well. That's San Antonio and Lake Charles area. All this pink is 1 inch, and if you're getting any snow in any of this pink, lucky you, because that 1 inch will be 10 inches of snowfall. But you can see the heavy precipitation in the New England states, according to GFS. It is showing what Euro is showing. It's showing heavier for Maine. It's also showing heavier amounts up to 3 and 4 inches for northern New York, Vermont, and New Hampshire as this system stalls for 2 days. In the full run with the GFS, bring light amounts of snow for the Midwest. A lot of y'all is going to see a lot of rainfall and mixed precipitation. It's just too warm. But it does bring some snowfall for the eastern Ohio Valley, parts of the Northeast, but heavy, major snowfall for New England states. And once again, the coast, just not going to be able to get it. But it will bring some snowfall, even major snowfall. It'd be a hit and miss. As it goes through daytime heating, you get nothing. Overnight, you're going to get snowfall. Daytime heating, you're going to get nothing. But sitting there stalling for 2 days, like GFS is showing, it could be up to 2 feet of snowfall for northern New York and northern Vermont. It is showing a major snowfall event because of that stall, because of the high pressures blocking it. And it's also agreeing with the heavy ice, not only for northern Maine, but it's showing also for northern Vermont. That's up to half an inch of ice. And it is showing some light ice could accumulate for the Ohio Valley. There is going to be a boundary where it's going to be freezing and not freezing. So that will be where your ice and freezing rain will be. And that's so far the updated information, guys. The video came out a little late today because obviously I had a lot of information I had to edit through for you. But it was stuff I wanted you to see. You need to know. And if it helped you in any way, please hit that like button. Show support for the channel. Thank you so much for visiting my channel today. And today I want to read Psalm 53. The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. Corrupt are they, and have done abominable iniquity. There is none that doeth good. God looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that did understand, that did seek God. Every one of them is gone back. They are altogether become filthy. There is none that doeth good. No, not one. Have the workers of iniquity no knowledge? Who eat up my people as they eat bread? They have not called upon God. There were they in great fear, where no fear was. For God hath scattered the bones of him that encampeth against thee. Thou hast put them to shame, because God hath despised them. Oh, that the salvation of Israel were come out of Zion. When God bringeth back the captivity of his people, Jacob shall rejoice, and Israel shall be glad. Amen. God bless you all today. Hope you have a very blessed day today. I know you will. Thank you again for visiting my channel. Thank you again for your time today. I do appreciate it. All power, all glory does go to Yahweh, God of Jacob. Amen. Hallelujah, guys. Have a very blessed Wednesday.